Hi, this is Tony and Ian from Tektronix.
Hey, how you doing?
We're back with another video. This one's about something that's all around us.
Then we're talking about wireless.
Wireless networking, it's everywhere these days, isn't it?
Man, it really is. I mean, I saw glasses the other day to household appliances.
Hang on a second, I just got a message.
Did you turn that thing off?
Looks like my dishes are done.
Let's get those later, Ian.
So anyway, no matter what part of the engineering process you're focused on, you're probably going to come into contact with wireless networking. Like,
sure.
Let's say you're designing a circuit board that's going to go into some consumer electronics.
Like something like this, something we've all seen.
It's probably going to have to connect to a wireless network. Or, let's say you're a technician and they've given you a whole pile of boards and said, test these and find out which ones are working, which ones aren't.
So this video is going to show how we've made that easier for you.
That's right. This could have been a long and complicated video with a lot of expensive equipment.
But we know we don't like long videos.
So we're going to show you how to do this quickly and easily with the oscilloscope that you've already got on your workbench.
Love this instrument.
The MDO4000B Mixed Domain Oscilloscope, together with the SignalVU-PC software running on a laptop.
Yep. And this video has two parts to it, right?
That's right. We're going to show you some shortcuts in the SignalVU-PC software itself to get to those WLAN answers more quickly.
That's great.
And then we're going to also show you something new, the new con option or live link between the SignalVU-PC and the MDO so that you're now capturing and analyzing data live as you're acquiring it.
And that sounds terrific. So no more thumb drives.
No more thumb drives. Shall we get to the lab?
Let's go right away.
So here we are. We have a SignalVU-PC mm-hmm. on a laptop.
And it's got the con option installed, which is what brings us this WLAN analysis stuff. And we've got a canned WLAN signal that we've acquired on a piece of real hardware and then brought it over here to the software to analyze.
Okay, and we're going to pick a few different screens to analyze it with.
Yep. So let's start with the spectrum emission mask display. This gives you an indication, am I even transmitting something that looks like a WLAN signal?
And that's the first thing you really want to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
So as we can see, we have something that looks a lot like a WLAN signal. It even fits under the mask, gives us a passing indicator. The next thing we want to know is it pulsing on and off the way it should? So for that, we turn to the time overview. And we see that, yes, indeed, the signal is pulsing on and off the way a WLAN signal should.
So we're two for two now.
Yep, two for two.
Now we're going to the third one.
Yep, the constellation diagram. Yeah. So this gives us a clearer picture of, are we actually transmitting a clean signal?
This has always been an interesting one to me. Such a, it's a clear indication.
I love this. Yeah, you can see right away, is my signal hopping around in the phase space the way it's supposed to?
This one here is perfect, right?
I mean, it's pretty good. Now, as our signal gets dirtier, our stars in our constellation start to look a little more like nebulae. And we get something like this.
Oh, we don't want that.
And then finally, let's say we want some more detail about our signal.
Yeah.
So we can do the WLAN summary display.
And this is for those really scientific people that just want everything laid out for you.
It does give you a lot of data, but the nice thing is it also gives you a top-level pass-fail on a few different metrics, and it gives you things like the error vector magnitude and the IQ imbalance.
So we went through and selected these things one by one.
Right, and it was pretty easy.
Not too bad.
But there's a nice shortcut. So I'm going to close all these displays.
And that's what we like, right? Always ways to make it easier for us.
That's what we try to do.
Yeah.
So instead, I'm going to go to the preset menu and choose standards, WLAN. I'm going to pick the standard that we're looking at today.
This is great.
This happens to be an 802.11 AC signal. Click OK. It picks the frequency and the bandwidth that are right for that standard. Now you're free to customize these afterward. Like if I wanted to, I could go in here and change the frequency to 2.4 gig. But we start you off with the best set of defaults.
And these were all the ones that we just looked at.
Exactly. It put the best displays up for that standard that we chose in the arrangement that's most helpful to us.
That's excellent.
So we've been doing all this on a canned signal.
Right.
There's one more piece of the con option, which is...
And this is the cool part, yeah.
The remote option.
Yeah, and this is excellent.
All right, we can connect to an MDO4000B oscilloscope and do the same kind of analysis on live data that we're pulling in for the instrument. We've got an MDO4000B oscilloscope. It's got a wireless LAN signal going to the RF port. We've tuned it to the right frequency. We can see that, yes, indeed, there is a signal there. So now we're ready to take the device end of our USB port and plug it into the back of the MDO. Okay, so we plug in the other end of the USB cable into the laptop.
Makes sense, yeah.
Then we go to the Live Link menu, and we choose Search for Instruments. So it goes out, it scans the network, it scans USB, it scans GPIB if you got a card. And then it populates this menu with all the instruments that it found. So we're going to pick our USB instrument.
There it is, showing up easily.
We get a confirmation. And now our display is updating live with the data that it's grabbing from the MDO4000B.
Just as easy as that.
Yep.
That's great.
And if we want more information about the connection, we can hover over this little link here. Now, of course, this MDO4000B is just right across the workbench.
I made it pretty easy.
Yeah.
But, like, what if I'm remote?
Like, how remote?
What if I'm in my corner office? What if I'm in the gym working out?
What if I want a bike ride?
Hey, there you are.
Hey,
how's your field trip?
Yeah, good. Really good.
Would you look at that? Okay, so how did we do all that? It was really easy. We just plugged an Ethernet cable into the back of the MDO.
This is like two or three steps, right?
Yeah, I mean, just go to the Live Link menu exactly like before. You choose Scan for Instruments. Or you can enter an IP address manually. It verifies that it can find the instrument. It gives us a little confirmation dialog once it has. And now we are updating live just like we were last time. Only this time it's with LAN and the device can be anywhere. As long as you've got power and an Ethernet connection.
Wow. No more canned signals.
No more canned signals.
It's great.
Yeah, Ian, that was really easy.
Yeah, we just took our MDO4000B and connected it to a laptop.
And we did the wireless.
And the wireless tablet,
yeah.
All running SignalVU-PC. And we got right to the answers we needed for WLAN performance.
And those presets were really great too.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we can find more information.
That's right. There's a link in the description below to our Tektronix.com website. And until our next video, we'll see you.
We'll see you later.